Hello, I want to say thank you all for joining my channel. If you have any friends that are in the sublimation, rhinestone, or t-shirt business, let me know because that's what I specialize in. And today's video is going to be on sublimating masks. I'm sure there's tons of videos out there, but for my subscribers, you may be new to sublimation. And if you are, I want to help you. I do have some masks. I'm just going to do two of them today. This is a sublimation mask. As you can see, it's white here on the front, which I'm going to be changing that color in just a second. And it's blue on the back. These masks come from SilkySocks.com. And they have a variety of colors as well as other merchandise that you can sublimate on. But today we're going to use this. This is the pocket mask hexagon. And they do come in different colors. Like the straps, they have like black, orange, red, green, blue, yellow, purple, green. So whatever you need, go to SilkySocks.com and they can help you. So today I'm going to do two prints on this mask here. This is a blue mask and I've already printed out my design that's going to go on here. And as you can see in the background, I have the Epson Echo Tank 2720, and this is my sublimation printer. And this right here is a regular inkjet printer that I use for other things that I need. But right now we've already got our butcher paper here on the heat press. And the temperature for this project is 400 degrees for 60 seconds. You will need a piece of butcher paper because the ink from your design will bleed through onto your platen if you don't put anything down. So make sure you have some butcher paper. I purchased my butcher paper at GFS. It's like a restaurant supply store. It comes on a real big roll and it was like $18. So you will need butcher paper. You will need your mask. And you will need your design. I've already printed that out right here. So whatever design software that you are using, go ahead and print your design. Make sure you measure it. Everybody's is different. So make sure you measure your project or your design to whatever your item is that you will be printing on. And then secondly, you will need a second piece of butcher paper to go on top. So what I like to do when I'm sublimating is I like to cover up the strings on the side here so they don't melt or get any ink on them or anything like that. So I'm going to cover the sides up right here and right here. And this is just regular blank sublimation paper from things that I've cut off. I've cut these extra little pieces off of design when I'm trimming. So I do keep those, keep a few of them. But you want to go ahead and pre-press this. Get any moisture out of your mask or fabric. About 5 seconds. Now what you can do when you're sublimating these masks is you can tape them down. Me, I don't tape them down. When I first started, I did, but here's the design. It is printed in reverse, okay? Print in reverse for sublimation. Go ahead and lay your design over the mask. Make sure everything and every corner is covered. Everything looks good there. Everything looks good from the top. And like I said, if you want to use tape, you can use tape to tape down the sides. Get your second piece of sublimation paper and place it over your design. Now we're going to press this for 60 seconds at 400 degrees. So while that's pressing, I'm going to go over some things with you that you can be doing with sublimation. The holidays are coming, so there's plenty of items you can be doing as far as coffee mugs, tumblers, socks, of course, t-shirts, tons of items. If you go to, let's see, coastalbusiness.com, silkysocks.com, there's another one that I use. I can't even think of it right now. It's like a total blank. But they have a whole catalog of Sublimation items. If I think of it, I'll let you know and I'll put it in the description box. But there's keychains, just tons of things. Business cards. I do a lot of Sublimation and a lot of business with Sublimation, and it has made me a lot of money. We have about 10 seconds left. So once we're done, this will be done, and I'll go ahead and do the next mask. Okay, we are done with the first mask. Go ahead and remove your Sublimation, your butcher paper. And as you can see, the ink came through there. You can see it right there. Throw that away. I'm going to pull up the design, and there it is. See that? All the ink transferred. Let's go ahead and remove our tabs. You're going to throw all that away. And here's the mask. Okay? See how that white changed to blue? Yes. Okay, let's go ahead and do our second mask so you can see it done again. You will need a piece of butcher paper. You will need your Sublimation mask. This side is the polyester. This side is just the regular color of the mask. Go ahead and lay that down. Cover up your tabs. Some people like to tuck the tabs behind the mask. I don't like to do that because when you press, the imprint of the strings come out in the design. So I like to just do it like this way. Cover it up, cover the tabs up. Look like I need a little bit more coverage on this tab. Got another piece of paper. And I do like to use A-Sub Sublimation paper. Let's go ahead and pre-press 3 or 4 seconds. Everything nice and flat. We're going to pull in our design. This is the second design, same design. And wait 1 second, I need another piece of butcher paper. I have my second piece of butcher paper. Make sure you print your design in reverse. I do use A-Sub Sublimation paper. And what we're going to do is place this design right on top. Make sure you line everything up correctly. Everything is covered on the sides. Sides. And the top. And like I said, you can tape this down if you don't feel comfortable, if you think you're going to get some ghosting. Lay everything down, everything is set, make sure everything is straight. Second piece of Sublimation on top. I mean butcher paper, I'm sorry. Second piece of butcher paper on top. 400 degrees for 60 seconds. Okay, back to our discussion. Another company I use is jpplus.com. They have lots of Sublimation items, like tumblers, cups, plaques, more keychains, panels. That's another company I use for Sublimation items. And I have a video on this Echo Tank 2720 printer. If you need to know how to fill that up, Very simple. I bought that at officedepot.com and I caught it on sale. So it was $199 at the time. I don't know how much it is now, but that was almost 2 years ago. And sublimation paper, I use a sub 8.5 by 11 or 8.5 by 14, and you can purchase that off of Amazon.com. That's my go-to paper. I've tried other papers, but so far the a sub has been the best one for me. 5 more seconds, and our second sublimation mask will be done. And once again, we press this at 400 degrees for 60 seconds. Remove your piece of butcher paper. You can see all of that ink went through there. Make sure you put it to the side and throw it away. This is our print or design. You can see all the ink transferred. Remove your tabs. And here's your mask. TSU, Tennessee State. And this is your paper where your mask lay. Throw all that away. So that's about it. I'll try to leave all the links below. Go ahead and turn your heat press off because it does get hot. I don't know about you, but it makes my house hot. 400 degrees and you run this thing for a few minutes and it gets hot. But anyway, if you need any more assistance, I want to just say thank you. And I want you to make a lot of money because without me, there's no you. So you make money, I make money, I help you, you help me, whatever I can do to help you make money, because that's what the business is about. So tell your friends if they need any help, and I thank you all for watching.